Happy Valentine's Day, Nikki.
Looks like it's just going to be the three of us for dinner tonight.
Did you make your mother a card?
I'm on it.
Judd, what about you?
Dad, your breast smells like pussy.
It always does.
Ew, gross.
Nick, your family has no boundaries. They're like doctors without borders. If the doctors ate each other out.
Guys, can we just tone it down this year for Valentine's Day?
Tone it down?
Nikki.
Valentine's Day. It's wonderful. It's
a day of hugs and snuggles.
A time to spread your loving seeds.
It's a rolling, growing, pink snowball of stress that no one needs.
It's unhealthy expectations.
An opportunity to impress.
It's a yearly grim reminder that your life's a fucked up mess.
It's a dark and lurid history of deviant pagan kicks.
It's outrageously expensive. Just stay home and watch the Knicks.
It's a big fat middle finger to those who are all alone.
Whether sick or tired or uninspired, you still gotta bring the bone.
It's a clusterfuck of passions, an emotional tour de force.
It's a cuddly little cupid with the cock of a full-grown horse.
Valentine's Day, Valentine, I can make it through your day. Of candy hearts and chocolate sharks and every bullshit love cliché. The hard-ons and the heartaches, the pressure, pain, and fear. Valentine's Day, got to survive.
Andrew, and I don't mean this as a compliment, you look like a lesbian newsie.
Say what? You mean my Kangol Hizzy?
Oh, the hats. Why with the hats?
Guys, I happen to be playing it cool for Valentine's Day.
Oh, no, I know what you're going for. It's just the hat's awful.
I disagree, Red.
Red?
This proper topper may not lift your skirt, but by the end of the day, Missy will be eating out of my cool, clammy hands. I can already see the end game.